In this lecture, we are going to talk about the unsupervised learning and unsupervised pre-processing. Unsupervised learning and pre-processing. So in this test lesson, we will talk about the unsupervised learning method where there is no output or there is no teacher to instruct the learning algorithm. In unsupervised learning, the learning algorithm is just shown the input and asked to extract the knowledge from this data, to group up the data. In the unsupervised learning, there are the two kinds of learning. One is called as the transformation of data set and other is called as clustering. In the unsupervised transformation of data set, these are the algorithms which create a new representation of the data, which might be more easier to visualize, to understand for the humans and the machine learning algorithms. They can easily understand and the representation of this representation of data. A common application of supervised learning is called dimensionality reduction, where high dimensional data is transformed into a low dimensional data so that it can be better represented and summarize the essential characteristics of the features. A common application of dimensionality reduction is transformation of the data to two dimensions for the better visualization. If the data is transformed to two dimensions, we can easily visualize that data. Now the clustering algorithm partition the data into distinct groups of similar type. Consider the example of uploading the photos on a website. So what it will do, it will match the photo with the closest one and group them up. So if there are the photos of a person at a different time and different clothes and different background, then they will have the similarity and they will be grouped together. And such kind of algorithms or such kind of methods, they can be used for the face recognition applications. So the challenges that are required in unsupervised learning, the major challenge for unsupervised learning is that how we can measure the usefulness of the method. In unsupervised learning, algorithms are usually applied to data that does not contain any label information. So we don't know that the right output, what the right output should be. Therefore, it is very hard to say whether a model is did well or not. Before we start real unsupervised algorithms, we briefly discuss some simple pre-processing methods. Scaling methods do not make use of the supervised information and it makes them unsupervised. So talking to the pre-processing and the scaling methods. In the previous lessons, we saw the same algorithm and we saw some algorithm, for example, logistic regression and SVM. And those methods were very sensitive to the scaling of the data. Therefore, a common practice is to adjust the features so that the data representation is more suitable for the algorithm. So often this is simple pre-feature scaling and shifting of the data. So pre-feature scaling and shifting the data. So following code illustrates this example. So we install the MJLearn library using this method. So, and after that, what we are going to do, we will import the MJLearn library and generate some random data and we will plot that data. So now we illustrate that this is the original data and these are the subsequent scaling plots of using different methods. So the first plot in the data shows a synthetic data, which has two classes. One is red and other is blue. And the first class is in the range of 10 to 15 and other class is in the range of, I guess, 1 to 9. So the following four plots show different ways that we can apply the scaling on these methods. So this is the standard scaling, robust scaler, min-max scaler, and normalizer. So in the standard scaler, what it is done, it is a mean is subtracted and the variance is made as 1 for the features. So this is the one way, representation of the data. The other one is the robust scalar plot. In the standard scalar, we can't predict that what will be the minimum value and what will be the maximum value. Likewise, for the robust scalar, it is subtracted the it is subtracted the it is used the median and the quartile instead of mean and the variance. And likewise, standard scalar, we can't predict what will be the minimum and the maximum value for the robust scalar. Then it comes the min-max scalar. For the min-max scalar, the minimum value of the feature is zero and maximum value of the feature or the range is one. For all the features, for feature one, for feature two, feature one, the range is one, for feature two, the range is one, and so on. For the normalizer, it does a very different type of rescaling. It scales each data point. That feature vector has a Euclidean length of one. Feature vector has a Euclidean length of one, and it makes a kind of circle of the features. Features are represented in the form of a circle in this scaling. It projects data on the circle. This means every data point has a different number. Every data point is scaled by a different number. So normalization is often used when only the direction of data matters and the length of feature is does not important. So now we apply the rescaling methods for data transformation. Now that we have seen the different kind of scalings in the sklearn library, we will use the cancer data set and we apply the min-max scalar on it and see that how the data set looks like. So we are going to import the min-max data set and then we are going to import the best cancer data set and then we are going to apply the min-max scalar. So here what we do, we import the SKF and load best cancer data set and then we made the model selection. We import the method train test separate and then we separate the data into training set and testing set. Training set has 426 instances. Each instances has 30 features and test set has 143 instances and each instance has 30 features. As with supervised model we built earlier, we first import the class that implements the pre-processing and then instantiate it. So we use a min-max scalar and using the min-max scalar, we are going to apply the min-max scalar on the training data, X-train data. To apply the transformation, we just learned that is to actually scale the training data. We use the transform method for the scalar and the transform method is available in the sklearn library whenever model returns a new representation of a data. So here we apply the transform and using the transform, we can see that pre-feature minimum scaling. So this is minimum before scaling and this is the maximum value before scaling for a feature. For a feature vector, minimum before scaling and maximum before scaling. Then we apply the scaling and after the scaling, the minimum value has come to zero and the maximum value has come to one. So this is the transformed data that has the same shape as the original data. Features are simply shifted and scaled. We can see that all the features are now between zero and one. All the features are zero and one. To apply SVM to the scaled data, we also need to transform the test set. So we also transform the test set and by transforming the test set, this is the minimum of the features and this is the maximum of the feature. So here you might notice that for the training set, the minimum of the feature was zero and the maximum of the feature was one. But for scaling, the minimum of the feature is not zero and the maximum of feature is not one. So this is what is the reason behind it, the main reason behind it. For the scaling formula, we subtract the minimum of the training from the feature value and divide by the range of the feature. So this is due to this reason that We are using the minimum of training set and range from the training set. Therefore, although the training set, it has the minimum of 0 and maximum of 1, but the test set, it does not have the minimum of 0 and maximum of 1. So now what we do the other way, the scaling the training data and test the same way. We scale the training and the test in the same way and see how what does it mean. It is important to apply exact the same transformation for the training set and test set for supervised model to work on test set. The following example illustrates that what would happen if we use the minimum and range of test set before we use the minimum and the range of training set, and we see that the test set the minimum and maximum value was not equal to 0. Now we are using the minimum and the maximum of the test set, and we see that what would happen. So this is the code for that. You can just go through it. And after running the code, so this is the first panel, and first panel shows the original data is unscaled, unscaled two-dimensional data, where you can see that the minimum value are the different minimum and the maximum value for different features. Then the second plot is the same data but scaled using min max scaler. Use the min max scaler, and the minimum is of the features are close to 0 and the maximum of features they are close to 1 for the training set, but for test set is the same. It has no effect. We call the fit on the training and then call the transform on the training set. You can see that the data set in the second panel looks identical to the first panel. Only the ticks have been changed. Here the ticks was minus 20 to 15, but now it has been changed to 0 to 1 and 0 to 1. The third panel has been changed. Now all the features are between 0 to 1. So we can see that the minimum and maximum features of the test data, they are not in the range of 0 and 1. Minimum of test data, they are not in the range of 0 and 1. So now we talk to the third panel, show that what would happen if we scale the training data and test set separately. In this case, the minimum and maximum feature values for both the training and test set are 0 and 1. Minimum and maximum, they are in the range of 0 to 1, but the data set looks different. The test points moved incongruously to the training set. Test set points, they have been moved. The test points, they have been moved incongruously to the training set as they are scaled differently. A training set is scaled for the minimum and the range of training set, and test set is scaled at the minimum and the range of test set. So therefore, test set scaling is different and is improper. So this is the point that it was going to show, that we should use the same type of scaling for the training set and test set, even though the test set points are not at the minimum of the feature and the maximum of the feature. In the subsequent part, we will talk about the next dimensionality reduction and manifold learning. Thank you.